So the scandal of today is my book has been reduced to 10%, and so I'm like, oh my goodness, somebody's taking a hit at me, like, whoa, like, we don't like her. And I'm like, okay, so who is the one who is taking the extravagant slash at my book? And I'm like, well, I understand the CMYK is an ugly dealant. It made everything a little ruddier, and I've learned that. But you know, what am I supposed to do? Repeat. But anyway, so who is it? Who is it? You know, who is the extravagant hater that wants? And I'm like, well, maybe it's the homeless. Maybe it's the homeless altogether. They just want me to join them. You know, maybe that's the cool deal. You know, sometimes I feel like they're like a rally that. I will call them a precipient evil in a way, that they want more, because maybe with more they get power, and extra power, you know what I'm saying? So yeah, it could be them, somehow getting cranky. What? No, she can't make money, she has to be homeless like us, you know, maybe there's just like dredge downers, you know? So I'm kind of upset by that group. And then I'm like, well, who else? You know, it's not going to be anything. I don't believe it's going to be a past, like, lover that has turned an angst at me, because I think all things had been done. Well, I don't know. I can't say that, actually, because there are some that I know. I take it back, because some people get the wrong impression that they were actually my lover, and when in reality that was just work. You know, there's a difference. Sometimes it is work, and other times it is the lover. And I don't know how else to explain it, but yeah, take a brain check and on that one, and realize that, oh my gosh, I guess so. I guess I have to qualify what the lover actually is, and that will be somebody that I'd actually had a real boyfriend-girlfriend relationship with, and announced it to the whole world in such a fashion that it lasted longer than a year. How about that one? And all the others can just be wondering in the quandary. Yeah, maybe you will work. Just work. So, anyway, when I'm going on through everything here, I'm like, okay, so who would it be? Is it back to them again? Because I was evicted once in my life, that they're going to just forever, ever downgrade me in some way, because they get their jollies off on it. So it could be the evictors. And so I'm like, well, that's ridiculous. And then I'm like, well, maybe it's Amazon itself. Maybe Amazon is just doesn't love me. And I'm like, why doesn't Amazon love me? Maybe they're just like art critics or something. Maybe they're art critics now for a coloring book that has a Dr. Seussian tone. You don't like Dr. Seuss? Is that what it is? You didn't like all the stories? It's a coloring book and so it got reduced? No, it has stories in it. Lots and lots of stories. Content, you know, I'm not just a naysay away of nothing, of just here's a little image. So there, yeah. Oh my gosh, how ridiculous. So then I'm in this extravagant 10% reduction, which is like huge amount. It's just like they're trying to say, well, why bother, you know? Why bother at all? You know, you're already in the garage, just walk the streets already, you know, and I'm so sick of it. I am so sick and tired of this preponderant aggression at me over financial. So I am anyway, so I'm sick of all of you. And then, so what's the deal? I don't know. So I'm going through all of these photos. I have the photographs of the past, and I'm going through all of these photos, and I'm going, oh my God, if I was naked in half of them, maybe perhaps I would be extra amazing. And then people would, I don't know, maybe they would actually talk to me. Maybe that's all it is, you know? Maybe that's all it is, that I just, gosh dang it. I still can, I guess so. I still have that direction possible. But yeah, I have not seen a man that appeals to me for that, so I don't know. This is just becoming a dead-end lifetime. I'm not enjoying it at all. And yeah, I'm not enjoying it at all. It's just becoming a boredom. And so then I'm like, well, yeah. So I'm throwing away all these photos, and it's just like, And why do they keep those? And why do women get fat as soon as they get married? I don't care if they have kids. I don't care if they don't have kids. Why do they get fat? You know, is there some, like, what is it? You know, the man doesn't necessarily always get fat, but the woman, oh my gosh. I just tanked out. And it's just, like, just awful. Yeah, so it's just like living in self-hatred or something over the choice. I don't know. I don't understand it. Anxiety? Is it the anxiety, you know, because you have to keep that marriage so, like, tight. You know, you're like living, what do you call that, in that dependency. You live so dependent, you know. Maybe that's an anxiety eating, because you're so dependent on the marriage. Because it can't fail. And so in a weird way, it's a destructive thing, because the woman just ends up becoming an uglier self. And oh my God. Yeah. And so maybe that's it, you know, maybe that's, again, you know, maybe I'm saying that. And so all of the heavy women out there are going, forget it, they're Rubenesque, they can be heavy. And so they're mad at me. But I don't know, I think the man gets a little perturbed. I think the husband gets a little perturbed at the overeating wife, you know. And what's the reason? How come it has to start? How come we have to start eating, you know? It's just life didn't go swell. You have to take the extra food, extra bites, you know. It's just like emphatica of like being like this little child in a way. Being fed at, you know, what is that, the age? The comfort age, you know, we're just completely, you know, dependent, and the food is just has to be available, you know, and I can go back a long time ago, you know, and I had a boyfriend. He stole the food, and he made me fat, because he stole the food. I had to eat the evidence, and he made me fat, and so he actually pretty much was a bad thing for my ballet career. Because I could not, there was no way. I mean, I had to eat, you know, way too much every day. And so I could not keep my slim ballet dancing figure, because I had to eat the evidence. And so this type of thing goes on, you know. And so I'm like, well, if you have a husband that steals the food, well, then you're going to be fat. If you have any kind of, what do we call it? A trust issue, you know, you're living in trust. Trust, you know, you have to be truthful, you know. If you're not a thief, you know, I mean, it's like, what the heck? Yeah. And so you know, you can all run and say, oh, she got so fat there, and I'm like, well, I had to eat the evidence, you know. It's not fair. There were other reasons. There's a lot of reasons why women get fat, you know. It's not only because maybe they got pregnant or something. It's not that. It's because of, you know, sometimes ridiculous. So here I am being the truthful one, and yet I had to fall upon the sword of whatever extra food was provided. So it's actually ridiculously funny now, and fall on the cake of it, and destroy myself, and destroy my actual career. And I'm like, what an idiot, why didn't I just throw it outside? You know, I couldn't, because it had the labels and all of these things, you know, and I had to cut them up even more. You know, any of the plastic that it was packed in around. I mean, my gosh, what a terrible situation, because I would never steal or never thieve, you know. I don't know, maybe unless it's a really beautiful hot rod or car in front of me and I just have to take it and nobody's around. But no. The food made me fat. For that reason, I had to hide the evidence. So yeah, there's a lot of reasons we're dealing with this. Gosh dang it, I got just hideous. Hideous. So anyway, yeah. Anyway, don't worry everybody, be happy. I'm 10% off now. And imagine if that was one of my pornos, that would be extra funny. I'm 10% off, and I wonder who's doing it to me. Oh my God, what is this, gonna be the story of my life? Somebody's after me forever to zero? I mean, stop it.